Hey guys, and welcome to Should You Buy It, where all we do is talk a little bit about the game and whether or not we think it's worth the cost. In this episode, we'll be playing Stellaris, the science fiction lover's dream of a grand strategy game where your goal is to either conquer the galaxy or bring peace among worlds.
I told them it means peace among worlds.
So the first question that we always cover in these videos is what stage of development is the game in? And in this case, Stellaris is in full release and available on PC, Xbox, and PlayStation for $40. So what is Stellaris all about, and how do you beat the game? Well, you don't. You see, victory in Stellaris can be having full ownership over the galaxy, being aligned with everyone in it, or even maybe just beating your friend in a head-to-head. That, though, is part of why Stellaris is such a unique game. You see, in Stellaris, you will start out with a small homeworld in most games, and through expansion, combat, and exploration, you will advance your foothold on the galaxy. Each game will usually begin with the expansion and exploration phases. You send out your little science ships on a mission to discover new systems and what valuable resources they have to offer. You will also begin to research your first technologies that will help you establish yourself. Now, technologies in the game are cut up into three primary categories. We have physics, society, and engineering, each of which will give you different types of benefits. However, each category is also divided up into subcategories. A good example of this would be that in the engineering category, you can choose to take the industry subcategory within the main category of engineering. This will then unlock more things that you can research within that subcategory. Now, if all of that sounds a bit confusing for you, just remember that this is a grand strategy game, and thus has layers upon layers of depth built into it. But don't worry, as you don't necessarily need to know every detail in order to enjoy yourself and feel like you're playing well. And to be honest, we had no clue what we were doing the first time around, but we played and we still had a great time. Next, let's talk about the game's resources. You basically have 4 to 5 primary resources, which are used to do basically everything in the game. These can be things such as colonizing planets, building a huge armada of ships, and even just building a new mining facility. You're also given a couple of sub-resources, which are known as Influence and Unity. Influence is mostly what you need to take control over a new system and to declare ownership over other civilizations' territories. Unity, on the other hand, is primarily a second sub-technology. Sorta. It's hard to explain, but basically this just helps you unlock new things and gain the ability to do things faster. It's more like a talent tree from an MMO than it is something you research, like the technologies in the game. So let's pause for a moment and talk about the combat. Combat in Stellaris isn't quite like a normal RTS, like StarCraft or Age of Empires. Instead, it's done via one fleet making contact with another fleet. Upon them reaching one another, you basically get to watch a super cool laser show go off as they both fight to the death. Now, there's a lot more to it than just send them in and roll the dice. Although this video would be an hour long if I tried to explain every detail about it to you, but basically what it boils down to is just a few other things. You can go into a cool little side window where you're able to customize each ship individually and make them better against certain other types of ships. You can also hire admirals who will provide your ships and your fleet with buffs and unique effects. Next up, we feel that it is very important to talk about the DLCs for this game. The good news is that only the lobby host needs to have the DLCs in order for everyone else in the lobby to use them. The bad news is that there is a lot of DLCs. Now, some of these are hit or miss. For example, there are some DLCs that give you access to specific races with unique traits that are really fun and were not offered when the game first came out. A good example of this is the Lithoids. The Lithoids are basically a bunch of rocks who eat rocks instead of food, and thus all but eliminates the need for food as a base resource. Another one allows you to have new random events pop up in your games. At the end of the day, they range from $7 DLCs that just give you new skin packs to $20 DLCs that add tons of new content to the game. Finally, let's finish off by talking about the galaxy customization. One of the coolest things about this game is that it allows you to change the settings of your galaxy to fit exactly what you want. Everything from the victory time to how many AIs are in the game to even what difficulty you want it to be set to are fully customizable. They even allow you to customize your own race before you start each playthrough. A good example of this is you could be humans, bird people, weird tentacle monster things, and they even allow you to change whether or not your species are afraid of other alien races. They also let you go as far as to decide if you want your society to be a monarchy where you're the king and all must do as you say, just to have your stupid son take over when you die and ruin everything. Or, you know, you could be a democratic society where your leaders are voted in every year. I think we all know which one's the best here, boys. Let's be real.
So now let's move over to the pros and cons section for the game. First off, we have that the game has a very large amount of depth to it. It always feels like there's something more to learn about the game, no matter how much you've played it, and to me, that's a great thing. Secondly, the game has a great replayability value. I mean, aside from all the customization, it's really cool to come back to the game after a while, and be able to play against all your old empires while they're being controlled by AI. Next up, we have the simple fact that only one player needs the DLC. I know a lot of other companies don't do this, and I understand why, but man, it is just a really nice feature about this game. Finally, we have that Stellaris just has a great atmosphere. It goes for a sci-fi universe feel, and oh boy, does it live long and prosper.
And next up, we have the cons. First up, we have that there's just a lot of DLC for this game, and I understand that's not always a bad thing, but in this case, there is over $100 of DLC for a $40 game, and to me, that just doesn't sit right. And finally, for the cons, we have that there is a really poor tutorial in a game that is super complex, and I'm grateful that it's there and all, but it really needs to go more in depth and teach you the inner workings of the game.
So that brings us to the rating for the game, and when we rate games, we want to get 1 hour of enjoyment out of every $1 that we spent. So for this game in particular, in Stellaris, we would want to get roughly 40 hours of enjoyment out of the $40 that we spent on the game. And after putting 24 played hours into this game, we give it 8 out of 10 potatoes.
Yeah, and when it comes to wanting to play a science fiction fantasy game, I would definitely look no further than Stellaris. It really makes you feel like you're a part of the universe, and it has this odd ability to just suck you in and make you lose an entire day of your life playing it. I really wish there wasn't over $100 in DLC, but aside from that and the lack of tutorial, I would definitely say that Stellaris is worth the cost.
Now, if you want more money-saving content, consider subscribing to our channel, where we release new videos every single week where we spend the money so you don't have to. Make sure you guys smash that like button, and as always, thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next time.